Good morning, student. Today we are discussing about chapter 3, fiber to fabric. Dear students, as you all have previous knowledge about fiber to fabric, now my question is that what is a fiber? Here fibers are very thin thread like strands from which fabric or cloth are made. That means they are very thin structures and are derived from cotton, wool, silk, flax, jute, nylon, polyester, polyacrylic. These are the few examples of fiber. Now, next question is, what is a fabric? The fibers, these fibers, which fibers? These fibers are spun. This spun process is done in spinning wheels, that is in Hindi charkha, or in a other machinery, into that will be spun into yarn which can then be woven. Weaving is a process through fabrics are made, woven on a loom. For weaving process, they are weavers use loom to make a fabric or cloth. See, these looms are actually operated by hand, that is known as hand loom, and operated, if operated by machines, that are known as machine looms. Next word is yarn. It is a kind of long thread. It is made from fibers by the process of spinning. Again, this spinning word is coming here. This spinning is actually done in machines. Now, types of fibers. Number one is natural fibers and number two is synthetic fibers. Natural fibers are those which are derived from plants. Actually, fibers are either plant products or animal products. Plants, that is plant fibers, are cotton, jute, flax. These three plant products that you have been learning in your previous class. Now, animal fibers are wool, that is fur of animals, and silk. These two types of animal fibers are to be learned in this chapter. Next one is synthetic fibers. Synthetic means artificial, that fibers are prepared in laboratories, which are synthesized in mill also. Example, nylon, polyester, acrylic, etc. Now, animal fibers. In this class, we have to learn about animal fibers. In previous class that you have learned about plant fibers. Now, in animal fibers, mainly we learn about wool and silk. Now, what is a wool? It is a animal fiber. Its source is sheep, goat, yak and other animals. Now, my question is that why animals have a thick coat of hair? That means these furs have been derived from animals' skin. So, why they need thick coat of hair? You have to find out this answer, and next day you will be given in your homework. Main states that are engaged in rearing of animals for wool are Tibet, Ladakh, Jammu and Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, Uttaranchal, Arunachal Pradesh, Sikkim, plains of Haryana, Punjab, Rajasthan and Gujarat. Now, these animals through which we get wool are reared by shepherds. They take care of herd of sheep during their grazing. जब वो घास खाने जाते हैं, उनके झुंड को, that is herd means झुंड, are being take cared by them, shepherds, that is known as charvaha. Now next question is, name Indian breeds of sheep that gives wool. You have to find out this answer from your textbook. Okay. Now, rearing and breeding of sheep has been followed by these are the steps that are followed during processing of fibers into wool. Now step one, this process is known as shearing, in which hairs of sheep have been removed with their dead skin, and this is known as fleece. Remember, hairs of sheep are removed during the hot weather. This provides wool. This removal of hairs which provides wool, see, shearing does not hurt the sheep. Now step 2, now these hairs are to be washed in tanks to remove grease, dust and dirt, and the process is known as skewering. Now step 3, since animals have different length and textures, so that has to be separated first, this process is known as sorting. Now next, step 4, the fibrous part of hairs, that is hairs, are include burrs. These burrs are actually fluffy fibers that are to be picked out from the hair. Again, skewering process being repeated, and then fibers are to be dried. Dried means usko dhoop mein sukhana. Now next step is 5, the natural fleece of sheep and goat is black, brown or white, so that these fibers are to be dyed, means unko rangai karna, color karna in various colors. Next step is step number 6, these fibers are then straightened. Inko pehle seedha kiya jata hai, then combed, unko कंघे से उनको उलझनों को ठीक किया जाता है, सीधा किया जाता है, एंड देन रोल्ड इनटू यार्न, और उनको फिर रोल करके यार्न में तैयार कर देते हैं. द लॉन्गर फाइबर्स आर मेड इनटू वूल फॉर स्वेटर्स. सी, यहां पर कैटेगराइज है, दिस फाइबर्स आर कैटेगराइज इनटू लॉन्गर एंड शॉर्टर वन. दिस लॉन्गर फाइबर्स आर मेड इनटू वूल दैट विल बी used in sweaters, and shorter fibers are spun. उनको spun करके क्या करते हैं, that woven into woolen cloth. Now occupational hazard related to wool industry. Sorters, those peoples whom they are been engaged in this industry are being affected by anthrax bacterium. This bacterium produces a deadly disease that is known as blood disease. Now next animal fiber is silk. First of all, sericulture is a word which is used to denote rearing of silkworms for obtaining silk. Now here I draw a picture of life cycle of a silk moth. Here we see two silk moths, one is male and another one is female. Female produces many eggs in mulberry leaves. Mulberry is a fruit. This female lay eggs on mulberry leaves. There on leaves larvas are been produced, or after hatching larvas have been produced. These larvas are known as silkworm. These silkworms actually feed on mulberry leaves. After a few days, these silkworms are get packed or closed by special type of structure that is known as cocoon, and this cocoon is actually being prepared by protein. That protein have been secreted by caterpillar. This will being hardened on exposure to air and become silk fiber. After that, this stage is followed by adult moth.